See, you don't need to believe in God or in Jesus Christ to prosper materially. You don't have to. So if all your Christian efforts, all these struggles you are making to come to church, to forgive your enemies so that you will prosper materially, you are wasting time. And you'll be frustrated. The reason for all this is so that you will be. Because at the end, when you go to heaven, remember when we were growing up, one of the things they were using to teach us about heaven is, you know, children like rice and stew with meat, Abby. I remember those days they would tell us, hey, in heaven, everything is perfect. When you are hungry, all you need to do is to press one this thing. Rice will appear. You know, we children this thing, and we just picture it like that. Oh, this rice that our mothers will measure and give us, measure meat, they will tell us, in heaven, just anything you want, order. I know some people are still having that idea of heaven, and they are reflecting it here on earth. You think when you get to heaven, all the things you enjoy, you begin. That's why some terrorists are told that 72 virgins are waiting for them in heaven. You think in heaven, you will enjoy by having. No, my brother, in heaven, your enjoyment is by being. Because in heaven, you are totally transformed. And you begin to enjoy or see life the way God sees. Not by having, but by what? By being. 1 John chapter 3. He said, now we don't know what we shall be, but we shall be like him. When we see him, we shall now totally become like him. And Jesus wants us to bring back a bit of that mentality into our Christian life. The rich man who came to Jesus and said, sir, what must I do to be saved? He said, keep all the commandments. He said, but I've done all this. Jesus said, in order to be perfect, to be different, do what? Sell everything you have. Give the money to the poor. Then do what? Come and follow me. What did the man do? He went away sad. He preferred having to be. The apostles reversed that. Peter, James, and John, and Andrew, they were fishing. They had boats. They had the occupation. Then Jesus came and said, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. He didn't say, I will give you bigger fishing company. He said, I will make you, in other words, you will become another person that you are. An identity. That's what he offered them. And they followed. They left having and started following being. He destined us in love before the foundation of the world that we should be holy and blameless, to be conformed into the image of his beloved son.
Sign up with the largest community of Catholics online. Meet new friends, chat, post pictures and videos, make and receive audios and video calls, interact with lots of priests and religions. Download the app from Google Play Store.